a new video on how to work with liquid latex. It isn't the liquid latex paste once again, but it is liquid latex and cotton wool. So these two can create amazing special effects makeups. And just to show you small things you can do with it, I created this new nose for myself and just a small wound on my cheek. Well, if you are curious on how to work with these two, please keep watching because I will show you step by step in the coming video. Back to a new video on how to work with liquid latex. I did the how to work with it and tissue a year ago. I did the latex paste video last week and I thought, well, let's just continue with the liquid latex videos until I have them all on YouTube. Otherwise, I probably will forget about them again. And well, then it takes years before I have all the how-to videos on latex online. So I have the Liquid Latex Clear by Meron. This is my favorite go-to liquid latex with any special effects makeup that is done directly on the skin. And today we're gonna work with the liquid latex and cotton wool. I have created many videos here on YouTube using the cotton wool and latex combination. The first thing that comes to my mind is the Grand High Witch I did for Halloween last year. I built up the entire witch using these two products, and I probably have some more. Maybe I will link them in the description box down below if you are interested in other looks you can create with it than what I'm gonna do today, because today is all about showing you and not about a real, well, Halloween look I am gonna make. Working with the liquid latex and cotton wool is very simple. It just is a messy process to start with, and once I go and put it on my skin, you will definitely understand what it is I'm talking about. Let's dive right into this video. I think I will make a wound with this combination, and maybe I will give myself a new nose to show you that you can really build up with these two. But first, let's get some latex on the skin and the cotton wool. I will first get the latex in the cup again so I can work with it. To get the latex on my skin, I am using my spatula. I know that there are a lot of people using foam sponges, those foundation sponges to put the latex on the skin. I think it's easier to use a stainless steel spatula, but that is a personal preference. So if you like using sponges, go ahead and just use those. Don't use your good makeup brushes, because if you get latex in them, it is very hard to remove and you probably need to throw your brushes out at the end, and that is definitely a shame if that were the case. So don't use your good brushes to work with latex. So I am going to make a small wound on my cheek, and just to show you how you can build up with cotton wool and latex. So this first layer is just to stick the cotton wool too. And if you want to make something like a wound, you don't really want to use a very thick layer all at once. So I just have the tiniest bit of cotton wool and I will stick it on the latex I just put there. And once it's on your skin, you want to cover it with latex again. So the cotton wool has all these little fibers in there and that is a bit messy. Extremely messy if you want to build up a large thing. So as you can see, I'm pulling on those fibers and they come loose from the skin. You can just get them back in place with your spatula and make sure you cover the entire cotton wool with latex. As I want to keep this small, I'm gonna try to get a wound in the little bit I just put on my skin here. So I'm gonna clean the spatula and just attack the middle of this. When you put the latex over the cotton wool, you do want to spread it out and make a nice transition from the cotton wool to the skin, because otherwise you will definitely keep seeing that edge from skin to cotton wool. And with spreading it just on the skin a bit. You don't have to put latex on your entire face, but it helps to let those edges be, well, invisible to the eye once the makeup is on there. So this has to dry. It takes about, well, 5 minutes, I guess, for one layer to dry. You can speed up this process with a blow dryer, but once it has dried, we can continue to the next layer of cotton wool. As you can see, the latex dries clear, only the cotton wool, of course, stays white. Well, we will color it in the end and I will show you how you can get it into a skin tone. But first we have to work on the inside of this wound, because that is very smooth for a big open wound like this one. So I am going to put a little bit of latex in there again and just tiny bits of the cotton wool to make it into an uneven surface. So I'm kind of rolling the cotton wool in tiny shapes to put them onto the latex. You don't really have to think about this, but don't make them too large, of course, because then they will stick out the wound too much. Just to make a nice growth inside of the wound. And there will be blood in there at the end, but I just want a little bit of texture in there to help me make this into a gross wound. And I will cover that with latex again. Maybe they want to come out and I can move them on the skin a little bit. As you can see, the liquid latex dries transparent. The white bits you still see is the cotton wool. We will color this in a skin tone at the end of the video. But before we will color this, I will just make myself a new nose to show you how you can build up on the cotton wool. So I will just put a little bit of latex on my nose and I will start at the part that I want to be the highest, so I can build up on that bit most with all the layers. So there is the start for my new nose, and I will cover this with the latex like I did on the wound. That is the first layer of my nose. As you can see, I wasn't really fussy about the edges and, well, make it all nice and smooth. It is just the buildup. So the next layer will be a bit bigger and, well, we will continue until I have a new nose shape. But this needs to dry. I will quickly get my blow dryer and blow dry it so we can continue to the next layer. Yes, and I know that it's just two layers on my nose, but I think it has, well, changed quite enough from the original. I will just smooth out the edges a bit using my finger dipped in liquid latex. And once that is done, I think I will just let this one dry. On to the coloring of these wounds, or actually it is a wound and a new nose, but well, usually I just get my Encore alcohol activated skin tone palette and my blood palette or my injury palette and I go and color it. But I thought, well, let's just change it up a bit for once, and that is why I got my ultra color palette by Dashbo from my kit, and it contains of skin tones, and you can use it to color a latex makeup as well. So I'm not going to use it as they are in the palette, but I'm going to scoop them from the palette a bit and put them on my mixing palette so I can tint them down with alcohol a bit. And I find it is easier to color the latex with tint down grease paint instead of just the pure product, and I will show you this now. So I'm just getting a bit of the mid-brown color and put it on the palette. I think it is too dark for me, but well, it is a nice base to start with. I dipped my brush in alcohol. I'm just activating the grease paint a bit with the alcohol, and as you can see, it tints it down straight away. And once I have a nice consistency, that will give me coverage as well. I am going to put it on my skin just by dabbing it like I would with the alcohol activated makeup. And the alcohol will evaporate and the grease paint will stay on the skin. So it is a nice way to work with grease paints, in my opinion. Yes, that is for the coloring of my skin tone. I'm happy with it as it looks at this point. I'm not really happy with the nose. There are some tiny latex bits sticking out and I didn't blend it that well just between my nostrils. You can really see the edge of the latex, but that is just because I rushed creating the nose a bit too much. If you take a few more minutes at home when you are creating something like this, you won't have that. It is just, well, I wanted to do it quickly, but I guess I did it a bit too quickly. But well, I can't change it now because the latex is dry and I already colored it. But please know that that isn't something that you have to get when you make a latex nose or latex brow or latex cheekbones or a long chin. It is just me rushing it, and as you can see with this part, it is quite nice and even and it has blended on the skin. So just take your time when working with latex and cotton wool. On to the coloring of the inside of the wound, and as I did everything with grease paint, I think it's only suitable to put grease paint in there as well, and that is why I'm going to work with the Burns and Blisters Wheel by Benai. I'm using the same technique as with the skin tone. I have put a bit of the grease paint on my palette and I'm just thinning it down with a bit of alcohol. So I just chose the red and the dark bluish color to color the inside of the wound. As it is grease paint, it mixes and blends very well on the skin, and I think that with these two colors I have enough to create an interesting looking wound in a bit. So I'm just coloring everything in the light red color, and here goes the blue, purple, black color. Easy enough, just two colors of grease paint, and it does look kind of purplish. I am aware of that, but as I am going to add some clot paste to the inside of the wound, I think we will be just fine with this. I have the clot paste on my spatula and I will put it in the wound. That is the clot paste, and now I'm going to continue to Maron's Stage Blood. I haven't used this one in a video for a very long time, so I thought, well, let's use it again. As the bottle I have it in is very inconvenient, I'm just going to pour a little bit into a separate cup so I can work with it using a brush. It is a very thick liquid blood. It does have a flow to it, but in comparison to the blood by Modlife, for instance, it is really thick. And you don't really want to put a lot of this blood outside your wound, because if you go mop it up like I usually do with my tutorials, you will get a kind of a pinkish effect instead of the orange that you would normally get when mopping up, well, real wounds. So this is a lovely blood for Halloween, but it isn't one to put outside of your wounds. And that is all for the blood. Well, and that kind of completes my makeup tutorial for today, showing you how to work with liquid latex and cotton wool. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you learned something of this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay tuned on all our videos. For now, I wish you a wonderful day, and of course, I hope to see you back here next time. Bye!